May the name of Jesus be praised both now and forever. Welcome, my friends. This is Father Michael, along with the rest of the team. Thank you for joining us in prayer. You're listening to the God Minute. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips.
And my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 119. Only in you. O God, I want so much to please you, to walk in your ways, and to carry out your purposes. Nothing is as important to me as being in the center of your will and living within your design for my life.
While others may find their fulfillment in the acquisition of wealth or the accumulation of things, my foremost desire is to be the object of your love and to be your child and servant forever.
Not only have you fashioned me with your hands, O Lord, and created me for your purposes, you have stamped your image on my heart. Therefore, my deepest longings are met only in you.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
Reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Keep your lives free from the love of money and be content with what you have, because God has said, "Never will I leave you, never will I forsake you." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today the Lord speaks to us about gratitude and about courage. We may think that if we just buy into the promises of this world, that our lives would be so much easier. But this is not the way of discipleship. Christ urges us to follow him by taking up our cross. It takes courage to forsake earthly pleasures and comforts, all of which come from devoting our attention to money and to possessions. However, there is a key word in this passage which I think is very important for us to reflect on, and that word is free. Keep your lives free from the love of money. What God provides is freedom. No amount of money, fame, pleasure, or comfort can bring true freedom. Only God can. But what strikes me most about this passage is that our Lord is directing us to keep our lives free. It is our decision to live in freedom. We can keep our lives free. Do we have the courage to choose a life of true freedom? To leave behind what the world offers us, things that promise to make us happy, but instead leave us unsatisfied and always wanting more? Today, many of us look at others to fix the problems in the world instead of looking to ourselves. We assume that our happiness can be dictated by someone else's actions, that if everyone else would just act the way we want them to act, the world would be a much better place. It takes courage to look inward instead of outward. It takes courage to look at all of the opportunities that God gives us in our lives to grow in conversion and to begin making the most of them. The courageous person does not count the cost of discipleship, but instead steps out in faith, following the will of God. This reminds me of a situation in my own family history. My mother worked tirelessly taking care of me and my sister when I was a baby. She completed her degree in accounting by going to night school. As her career began taking off, she felt the call to become a stay-at-home mother. Both my parents knew that this would mean some financial strain and difficulties, but it was something they felt called to by the Lord, and they trusted that he would provide. my mother left behind her promising career to homeschool me and my sister. God provided for our family every step of the way through every challenge, and he continues to pour out his blessings on us because of this decision. My parents' example of courage and trust in the Lord are the reason why I have dedicated my life, my marriage, and my career to the service of his church. Their impact on my spiritual life is immeasurable. I hope that this word gives you comfort and you hear the call for a renewed trust in God. He is always there for you, and he will never leave you. All he asks is that you surrender to the promise he makes you, a promise of true freedom, of abundant life. He is a loving father who wishes to share all that he has with his children, and he is the source of all goodness, happiness, peace, and freedom. He is not asking that we have no money to our name in order to be holy. Instead, he asks that we recognize that he gives us freedom. He alone gives us all that we need. All of our gifts are from him, and we return them in service of him and his gospel. Let the name of Jesus be praised, both now and forever. Amen.
My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, his mercy rains, unending love, amazing grace.
Let us pray together the words that our Savior taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Holy Spirit, lead us, guide us, and walk beside us in our life journey. Break every chain and stronghold that keeps us from trusting in God and the true freedom he offers. Replace our fears with strong faith and wrap us in the love of your Son, Jesus, who is our Lord. Forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God bless you and your loved ones in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thanks everyone for joining us in prayer today. I'm always so edified by the vulnerability and deep faith we're so privileged to experience in this moment of prayer. I pray our time together continues to bring us all the freedom we desire. Brothers and sisters, be good to yourself and one another. We'll see you tomorrow.